Morning children. Children, today we'll continue our session. Okay. In previous session we just had an introduction about our lesson and we also learned types of matter. So what is matter? Matter is which has occupies space and which has weight. It's called matter, right? And matter can be divided into three types: solids, liquids, gases. So solids are where the molecules are tightly packed and which has a fixed shape and fixed value. Whereas liquids, the molecules are somewhat loosely packed than compared to solids, and they doesn't have any shape. They will take the shape of the container in which we pour it, right? And they can flow. Okay, yes. And the gases also, it does not have any shape and it has weight, and it occupy all the space in the container. Right? Yes. So matter have some properties. So matters, everything is a matter. So that's why matters will includes so many. Matters can have so many properties. Now in today's session we are going to learn about that properties, different properties of matter. Okay, first we will start with matter can be hard or soft. So we already know that matter can be anything. So which has weight, which occupies space, which has anything is called as matter. So it may be hard or soft, right? For example, this one is hard, okay? And this dust also is hard. Where comes to cloth? This cloth is soft, and sponge, cotton. These are very soft materials. So those are matters, and these are also matters. So matter can be hard or soft. Either hard or soft, right? Then comes to matter can be opaque. Opaque means what? First I will explain the terms, then I will show what is opaque, what is transparent, and what is translucent. Okay, opaque is a thing which does not allow any light to pass through it. So it does not allow, we can't see from that opaque object other portion. Okay, so it does not allow any light to pass through it. Then transparent, we can see easily from outside. Through that we can see easily outside portion, like a glass, a window, a bus glass, a car glass. So these are all transparent. It allows the light through pass through it. It allows the light pass through it. That is transparent. Where is translucent? What is translucent? Translucent is one thing which has only some light, not whole light like transparent, but it allows only some light to pass through it. Okay, now I will show how the light will pass through through these three types of different objects. Okay, yes, for this I have to first switch off the light, then I will show how the light can pass through these three different objects. Okay, yes, so I have the torch. So the book is a good example of opaque. So we can we see from this book outside what will happen? Can you see so what is on the board? Through this book we can't see, and so it does not allow any light to pass through it. So light stops here only, it does not pass through outside. So the light does not falls on the board, right? So this is opaque. It does not allow any light to pass through, to go through it. This is fine example of opaque. Okay, and then comes to transparent. Transparent, which allow the lights to pass through it. See, so this is the glass. So we can, the light can easily pass through it. We can see the light on the board, right? Yes. So the light can easily pass through it. This is transparent. And translucent. What is translucent? It allows only some part of light. So this is the thick glass. So it allows only some part. See, only we can see some light over here, not full as this transparent, that glass object. So it allows only some light to pass through it. Okay, whereas this transparent object, that is glass, see, it allows the full light to pass through it. Okay, right? Yes. So this is about opaque, transparent and translucent. Okay, I hope you understood what are the types of things through which the light, okay, this the light can easily pass through transparent. Some light will only pass through it translucent, and no light will pass through it. This opaque. Okay. Okay, beta, understood? So opaque is the object, the light which does not allow any light to pass through it. Transparent, the light can easily pass through it. Translucent, only some part light can pass through it. Okay. Yeah. So matter can be anything. So this is the matter. It has weight, it occupies space. This is transparent. It is matter. It has weight, it occupies space. It is translucent. And this book is also matter. It has weight, it occupies space. So it does not, and it is opaque. So matter can be either opaque or transparent or translucent. So it can be anything. So it is the one of the property of matter, right? Okay, done. So matter can be poor conductor or good conductor of heat. So conductor means what? Poor conductor and good conductor. What is poor conductor? What is good conductor? Poor conductor means it does not allow any heat to pass through it. And poor conductor. Poor conductor means it does not allow any heat to pass through it. And good conductor means which carries heats very quickly. Which gas heat very quickly. Okay. So matter can be anything. Some matters can be poor conductors. Means they does not allow any heat to pass through it. For example, this is a matter, a wooden stick. Okay. So if you put the wooden stick in a bowl, which is on the stove, so this wooden stick will not be heated, because wood is the bad conductor of heat or poor conductor of heat. So the wooden stick will not be heated. Okay, this is a matter. For example, if you put this steel spoon in a bowl which we are cooking, so on the stove, so it can be heated very quickly because it is a good conductor of heat. So it catches heat very quickly. So this you can put this spoon in a in a curry, just lift it over there, and after sometime if you touch it, it will be heated, but it will not be heated because it is a poor conductor of heat. It is a good conductor of heat. It heats up very quickly. It does not heats up quickly. Okay, yes. So if I hope you are all having the cookers in your pressure cookers in your houses. So this material, you can see, so this black material is called bakelite, made with bakelite. This is the bakelite material. If you observe, if we put the cooker on that stove, so after cooking the dal, we can easily catch this because it is a bad conductor of heat and it does not heat. So we can easily, the heat pressure cooker, hot pressure cooker, we can easily catch with this bakelite material. Okay, because bakelite does not allow any heat to pass through it. So it is a very bad conductor or poor conductor of it. So it does not allow any heat to pass through it. This is the bakelite material. This black. And if you touch this, you will get hurt because it is very hot. It is a good conductor of it. This is aluminium. Aluminium. So it is a good conductor of heat. Right? Now you understood what is good conductor and what is bad conductors of heat, right? Yes. So again, one thing, copper. If you see the wires, the electric wires, in which you can see the copper wires. Why the copper wires will be used in this electric wires? Because it is a good conductor of electricity, and electricity will easily pass through it, this copper. Silver also very good conductor of electricity. But why the people will not use silver instead of this copper? Means silver is a precious metal. Okay, beta. Silver is costly. That's why people will use this copper. Copper is also very good conductor of heat. So if you observe, most of the electric, not most, almost all electric wires has copper wires in it. So these are the good conductor because electricity will easily pass through it. And this rubber is a bad conductor of electricity. You already know what are the bad conductors of electricity? Wood and rubber. Okay, so copper is a good conductor. If we touch this copper, if the socket is plugged inside, we may get electric shock. That's why the rubber, this is called insulation, the layer, upper layer part is. So the copper wire is insulated by this rubber because rubber does not allow any electricity to pass through it. So the electricity will not pass through this rubber. That's why these copper wires always covered by this rubber. So this is called insulation, right? Insulation means the upper layer. It will covered by this rubber. The copper wires are covered by this rubber. So the rubber is act as insulation of this electric wires. Got it? So you know you know about what is good conductors and what is poor conductors of matter. So matter can be good conductor. Everything. So this is matter. And this wood is, wood stick is matter. Stool, everything is matter. But it has different characters. Some are good conductors or some are poor conductors. Okay? Yes. And matter can sink in or float on water. So everything is matter. Matter can be sink. Means if you can put a sand or a rock in a bottle of, bucket of water, it will sink. Or any iron object, if you throw any iron object in a bucket of water, it will sink. It has weight. But if you put some what we call a piece of this lightweight objects like rubbers, very small toys or small balls which has very less weight, you can throw them in water, it will float on the water because it has less weight. So both are matters. So matter can be sink in the water or can float on the water. Okay, so if we throw a piece of food, small piece of food which is a lightweight on the water, it can flow. If you keep a nail in the water, it will sink. So these both are matters. Some will sink and some will float on water. So matter can be sink or can float on water. So these are the some of the characteristics of matter. So in this lesson, we learned about four kind of characteristics. Matter can be hard or soft. It can be opaque or transparent or translucent. Either it can be poor conductor of heat or good conductor of heat, or poor conductor of electricity or good conductor of electricity. And it will be sink, it can be sink or it can float on water. Okay, so these are the some of the properties of matter. So this is enough for today. I hope you understood the session, and we will meet in the next session by few more properties of matter. Okay beta, till then have a nice day. Bye bye.